an Estes lineup. Of course, it is quite popular in the Philippines
definitely
as well. But again, man, what a day we're having right now. Huge games, to say at least. Here we go. That is the Chango
immediately banned by
yes.
Sun Sparks.
Of course.
We saw Team Evil Esports actually just pick this once, Chango. Yep. But, you know, statistically speaking, Sun Sparks, they have not been that successful against
Chango. Okay, now their second ban will be the Esmeralda. Meanwhile, Evil Esports is gonna ban out the Masha. Here, eliminating the split push potential that Fuzeken and the rest of the crew can do. 28 seconds left onto the banning phase. Look at this, Evil Esports really planning this out, taking their time on who to ban. Again, we've talked about this time and time again. For the side of Sun Sparks, they do have a very flexible draft in terms of the tanks, right? So I'm guessing that
their team is putting
an end to this early game split Parrot. Aggression that Sun Sparks can offer, as they will now pick the Harith.
It's the Harith to be the priority for Sun Sparks. I like that they're still keeping their confidence this
right,
time.
Right. Look at this.
However, if Evil Esports, they might go for the Kufra this time to go with the Hylos.
Yeah.
Or either or. They might go for the Hylos first.
Whoa.
This time it's the Granger. They really have a different approach.
Yeah.
They did use They have not.
The
Kufra. Yeah.
Very unorthodox picks here coming in from the side of Evil Esports. But as of you said, as you predicted, it is, of course, the Kufra and Granger. They immediately secured their late game here. Sun Sparks taking their time. They're hovering up the Grok.
They might go for Thams to go with this Grok.
Okay.
I don't suggest them picking another tank.
Cho.
I like this, however.
Yeah.
Cho is good for Sun Sparks because this can act as their offlane, but it is also a denied pick.
Yeah.
One of the most picked heroes today for Team Evil Esports is the Cho.
Yeah, of course. That is, of course, their favorite. Plus, it can act out as a flexible pick here for the side of Sun Sparks. We still don't know. Probably they will choose to use this as their side laner or their support. It will at least it will still depend here for the side of Evil, but they will go for their core. This is looking very scary now.
The Lunox
and the Granger damage right here for the side of Team Evil, and as you can see, they will eliminate that healing factor from the Estes.
Of course, the heal is coming out from this Estes. A support that probably is new to the people here in the global scene,
picking.
But we know that in the Philippines, this is one of their
best picks.
You know, picks. Yeah. And statistically speaking, Sun Sparks, they win during their MPL run. They don't win when the Estes is available for the opponents.
Yes.
This time they will ban it out. Maybe there's some bad blood between Sun Sparks and this hero. Maybe it's just, you know, some
that's the reason
bad
why,
omen.
Yeah. So the reason why they lost game 1 and game 2 against Onyx.
Your team
Evil Esports, man, lots of firepower here coming in from their composition.
Yeah.
You have the Leomord crits, the percent magic damage from Lunox, and the crits again from the Granger. So what they need right now is, of course, their last support. But as we've said, this Cho is either
is either
a side laner or a support. We still don't know if it's going to be the Xborg support or the Cho support.
Yeah, we don't know yet.
But we do know that JP is really good in using this Claude.
For sure. Now, Evil Esports, they can consider getting the Lolita or maybe an Akai this time against the Sun Sparks. It is really good against
the
Harith.
Yeah.
And this could be their additional, you know, initiator or crowd controller for Evil Esports.
I'm like what I'm seeing.
It's indeed the Lolita.
Yeah.
We did mention it's either the Lolita
or the Akai
this time. Now it's going to be a support Cho.
Yeah.
And a core ex-Borg, yeah, for Renzio, with Coach Leather Goods bidding goodbye to the team. It's going to be up to SunSparks on how they can execute this time.
I like what I'm seeing. I do feel that we're going to have that this game is going to be a bloodbath.
It is.
Due to the draft. I love the Lolita pick.
Yeah.
I'm non-biased, actually, but I do like the lineup of Evil Esports. They're keeping it basic.
Yeah, they keep
basic
it
core heroes and basic supports.
Yeah.
Nothing special, right?
I really love the last pick, Lolita, because it actually answers a lot. Like, for example, the Claude, even when the Blazing Duet is up, you can just put up the Bulwark
Shield,
and it's just a stun. You know what? When you pick the Harith, you want to take control of a certain area, and that's where a Lolita shines.
Yep.
When you don't, when you can be surprised on how much Lolita can have in terms of the in-game factor when he is in play.
Yeah, conquering territories is the name of the game here for game number one. One Evil Esports, one win away to secure that that upper bracket slot here.
Exactly.
Very interesting. Ladies and gentlemen, of course, for you guys to catch every battle, stream like Cray, get unlimited data for all apps with Giller Unlimited GX30 only with U Mobile. Here we go. We're just waiting out for the game. SunSparks, they look really nervous here, but look at the eyes of KLBJ.
Yeah.
Just very relaxed. Let's see, man.
Yeah, again, we're going to go back to what we were talking about earlier. Team SunSparks, they need to secure a 2-0 to get to the
right
upper
now.
Bracket
yeah.
because, again, they will get up to 7 points
yeah.
compared to Evil with just
this
6
is it.
Points.
This is it.
If they lose one game, they automatically will not be able to make it to the upper bracket. Yeah. But if they lose both of their series, there could be a chance for either Axis or Geo to get their slot instead. So SunSparks, what they need to do is at least get one win against Evil.
All right, let's see if that could happen.
5 seconds till the
enemy reaches
Smash the
battlefield.
Them.
Let's go into game number one. Renjo will be using the X-Borg, Fuzuken as a Grok, JP as the Claude, the Raflesha as the Cho, and Kiao BJ as this Harry.
Evil Esports now playing the red side. It's Katzing on this Granger. It's Luca on the Kufra. It's Mocker on this Lunox. It's Ash on this Joe. And Itachi from Konoha playing the Lolita this time.
Oh my, here we go. Oh my, from the Akatsuki clan.
What?
Coming here in Malaysia. Let's go. JP and Raflesha will just go for that early Crimson Lizard and will definitely get this Crammer. But Ash from Pallet Town, man.
Ash from Pallet Town have to back down this time against the members of SunSparks. You have to take note this Cho and this Claude.
Okay.
Oh, very nice.
Nice bait coming in from JP.
Using the momentum.
Yep, using the momentum just to last hit and get that Crammer. As we can see, 46 seconds left for the turtle spawn here in the bottom lane. We are now seeing the Kufra and the Lunox in the bottom side of the retaining the bottom side of the map.
Oh, Zaman Force
wants to get the buff. But meanwhile, you see in the camera, a quick push
definitely
coming in from SunSparks.
Because of the chrono dashes, it will be enough to take a turret. Now it's just 1 minute and 36 seconds. We know that this Harith does have a lot of objective taking potential because of the chrono dash and the Zaman Force.
Yes, of course. And they do know that the turtle will spawn here in the bottom lane. That's why SunSparks immediately went for the push. That is 177 crit damage. In those early stages of the game, coming in from the dead zone at a warning shot to say at least 2 minutes in.
Oh,
here comes KLBJ.
KLBJ Zaman Force is going to be committed, but the flicker away coming out from Evil Esports.
Here we go.
Now they disengage. The Dutch on the tire stage. KLBJ is quite low.
Whoa.
And the Lunox will take care of him. That's the first blood going in favor of Evil Esports. They're not done. They want to take the turtle this time, but in comes the export. The damage is there. The fire snakes will be dealt down, and the Blazing Duet is there, but it's not going to be enough. The turtle still on the Granger. The Lunox to be saved this time. No pickoff whatsoever from SunSparks.
No damage yet in two. Man, Yuminum Blast coming in from the Lolita secured the kills from the side of Evil Esports as we are now seeing the U Mobile replay. KLBJ miscalculated the Salmon Force. Three heroes from Sunsparks still very far from that clash. And man, with the amount of heroes here for the side of Team Evil Esports, they really won that fight.
Mobile replay, there is gonna be more. Very good ultimate, but there's no way of the dragon.
Whoa.
Of course, the Cho will be taking mega kill for the Luna.
Oh,
can they get more kill? BJ Chrono dashing away. And of course, the fire from Renzo. It's not gonna be enough. Luca able to run away. Fuzak and not gonna let the power of nature to anyone. And Evil Esports, they disengage. 9.5k already up for Evil Esports. Only 8k for Sunsparks.
Oh my, Mocker just mocking them right now because he is definitely at his maximum potential. This is what's scary about the Lunox, is that if you give her a good early game, the player can actually tower dive you every time.
Definitely.
Anytime.
And it looks like they will dive Fuzak again this time, but this is a Grok. Not the best target to go for.
Yep.
This time they will take, however, the core guard. They will
core
steal
guard.
This one. But Sunsparks will defend. A very good ultimate in here. The Lumen Glass gonna be gas, but the Grok already down for the count. Can they get more? Yes, they will. They get the second one. Third one, of course. Can BJ will run away with the Zaman Force, but the Claw trapped in a very bad spot and will be gunned down by the members of Evil Esports.
Keeping it basic is the name of the game from Evil Esports. Lots of fire damage in the early game. New mobile replay light right there. No damage whatsoever for the side of Sunsparks. Of course, they do have the Claude, which is actually a late game hero. Plus, the X-Borg is in the top lane for the split. Man, Evil Esports.
It's holding
on a show.
It's all about the early game for Evil Esports. We saw their past four games. They want to take control of the early game. That's why they take the Leomord. And now a very nice Grok block, but Luca jumps away.
Yep.
Courtesy of the Tyrant's Revenge, the turtle will be taken by the Lunox. It gets scarier by the minute because the Lunox does have burst set based damage. And if you add into account the power of the turtle buff, you cannot fight against that Lunox.
You cannot fight, of course, an 8% extra burn. Ladies and gentlemen, Evil Esports lurking in the mid lane, eyeing this first tier tower. They do want to open up the jungle and, of course, the other lanes from Sunsparks.
Oh, that is set up and the jump from the Bootra. Oh my goodness, they burst out the Grok and they will get more. The Cho will flick our way to the right. Now it's going to be Luca to find him. Will they go for more? I think Evil Esports, they don't want to necessarily dive because a pickup on the Grok is more than enough already.
Oh my, Luca.
Stretch it!
They will get the BJ! Oh no, man, this is looking bad for Sunsparks as Evil Esports very confident in landing those stretch, landing those skill shots. Plus the Dead Sonata really paying off. 2-10, ladies and gentlemen, 6 minutes in, just like what Squidward is saying, evil.
Every villain
is lemons
for Evil Esports. But what they're saying right now is everyone who they are facing up against can be considered lemons because they're just destroying everyone.
Destroying everyone. Too sour, man.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. Evil Esports, 10-2 with 20,000 in the bank, taking out three turrets already, only giving up one, and now they are poising onto the bottom lane. They catch up one once again. There's going to be the Way of the Dragon. Going to be committed by the Cho, but of course the ultimate from this Gopra is not gonna find anyone. However, Evil Esports, they are still controlling the map this time.
All right, let's see Itachi running away. Sunsparks hoping to get back from this very huge deficit. 7 minutes in, man. Evil Esports just—
oh, no way!
Look at this! Luca boxing out Kill BJ, and where's the play? No damage output whatsoever for Team Sunsparks, and that is a free turtle for Katzy 304.
I thought that we only see Luka in NBA, as the Rookie of the Year, but Luka from Evil Esports
is here.
Showing us
is here.
He's going to be the Rookie of the Year, but there is going to be Luka still. Luka. Surviving the ultimate will be there. He will die this time, but it's
going to
be the luminous last one. A connection coming up from Evil Esports as they take out two, but the shutdown of the Lulux, the double kill from JP. It's going to be up to Evil Esports how they will convert this. 3v3 in the middle, but Sunsparks, they say, we have to cease fire. We have to back down.
We need to discipline ourselves. But Itachi, that Numinum Blast, just like in the anime, popping that Sharingan and putting an end to three heroes for Team Sunsparks. Man, this is clearly Evil Esports, the Evil Esports game.
Definitely.
Sunsparks still buying time. They do want to give JP this
Luka.
Opportunity.
Watch
this
up for Luka.
Luka.
Almost Luka. Hitting that, but there is going to be the bouncing ball. Will they go for this? The stun. But of course, JP is going to be hurt. Definitely Ash. Can he catch up? And yes, he will. It's going to be a kill on the Claude. Ash and Luka.
Ash
this connection.
Luka,
my goodness. Evil Esports, they're just out for blood. And they're not stopping another catch up on this Pirate, but it's not gonna be enough though.
Luka going loco, that is the death zone. Manta mega kill coming in from the Granger, plus that extra grab coin. Itachi once again, very confident. Naruto is not in town to save your lives. 414, oh my, kill BJ with a slither of health.
Can you run away?
He can't. There's no stopping Evil Esports. That is the ultimate of the Hoopra, and that is the Lord for you, man.
Evil Esports, they're relentless. They do not stop. For the past few minutes, we have that stop with our play-by-play because Evil Esports is, they just keep on fighting.
They're not stopping.
They just keep on finding all of these kills.
And it wasn't Squidward who said that quote. It was Mermaid Man himself. Evil for Evil Esports, man. Look at this. More aggression coming in.
Oh, aggression does not stop. Itachi is angry. He wants more.
He wants to be
in the upper bracket.
He wants more.
Of the playoffs of MO1. Renzo having used the last insanity just to get away from Evil Esports.
Itachi.
Through the middle. There's the Lord. Manjin, what's going to happen here?
It's in their names. Evil.
Luka, no way.
There you go. Here comes Luka. Luka. Oh my. That is a Numinum Blast being charged here. Two-man knockoff. Two-man stun coming in from Evil Esports. 4-17. That is the Lord. And Evil
Luka.
Esports putting an end to the dreams of Sunsparks for game number one. Wow.
The kill machine.
The killing machines.
Evil Esports proving that they are the best in terms of taking down the opponents, picking them apart. In terms of action, Evil Esports, they are relentless. You saw that in the game.
Yes.
They did not stop.
Yes.
Every time they find
Every
an
time.
Opening, they just go for it. And with this, they get up to 7 points. They've secured their upper bracket berth. And surely, they're above the clouds right now. Turkey is on the map of Mobile Legends.
Welcome to Turkey, Malaysia. Welcome to Turkey.
Oh my goodness. I can't get over this.
But still, this is just game number one. This is clearly an upset for us casters as well. We've been talking about this bracket since last week.
Oh man,
but
you know what?
Oh man.
This is Luka going loco.
Luka going loco, like what we've said.
So crazy.
So crazy.
I'm going to say it outright. At least 4 Tyrant's Revenge connections on the Harith.
On the Harith and on
the
one.
At least 4.
And that was the beginning of the disaster.
Exactly.
For the side of Team Sunsparks. They were just too hasty on getting this turtle.